to get to here. Of course, tonight was the GOP debate.
Yes, that's true. Second one.
This is the second GOP debate.
Right, right.
Now, the two leaders over there on the Republican Party.
Right.
One is a real estate mogul.
Right.
Mm-hmm. The other guy is a neurosurgeon.
Yeah.
He's in the lead, the other candidate.
Right.
You were a senator. You were first lady. Mm-hmm. Secretary of State.
Right.
Is this possible that you have too much experience to become the president of the United States? Is that possible?
Well,
they have no experience.
You know, that's really up to the voters to decide.
Yeah.
You know, when you think about it, you can just sort of throw your head into the future, and you could have the White House renamed the Trump House.
Yeah, sure.
And you could have Dr. Carson doing surgery in the basement.
So we can make it all work.
We're adaptable as Americans.
Yeah.
You never know what to expect from us, right?
Yeah.
We can get it done. Yeah.
But Trump... is Trump going to make it? Is he going to last the whole way? How long do you think he will last? I mean, do you feel like he's going to go? Are you just maybe waiting back, like rope-a-dope style, until he just gets tired, and then he's tired, and you go, all right, out of the way, buddy. Yeah.
Well, look, I think that he's going to go as long as he wants to go.
Yeah.
And more power to him. I mean, that is one of the great things about this country.
Sure, yeah,
you
yeah.
Know?
You think
if you're over 35 and you're eligible as an American citizen, you can actually run for president. And so he's making the most out of it. I'm having a good time watching it. I find it... I find it amazing.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, you were saying how much experience and all of that, you know, I know how hard this job is. I know what you have to do to try to figure out how to do it well. I obviously watched my husband. I worked with President Obama. So I'm just sitting there thinking, imagine, you know, all of a sudden, you know, you're in the Kremlin and somebody comes rushing in and goes, oh my gosh, did you hear what President Trump said today?
Yeah.
So you go, oh my goodness, what does that mean? It might actually cause everybody else to just calm down because they wouldn't want to get it to be too excitable.
Oh, yeah, I see. So they're all going to try to bring it down.
Yeah, just try to bring it down. You know, it could be good. I'm not sure.
We don't know. It's very, very...
I love scenarios.
Oh, good. I like it.
Yeah.
I see a lot of... I think you're very, very, very tough. I know, but you're a mother, and I know you as a grandmother as well, but you're a tough mother.
A tough mother?
No. I meant that in a good way. I meant that in the best way. You are. I mean, seriously, you are. You're like. I wouldn't mess with you. No, I wouldn't not mess with you. I wouldn't fight with you. You're like if Ronda Rousey shopped at Ann Taylor Loft. You know what I'm saying? You were like. You know what I'm saying by that? A lot of people would go, like, oh, are you tough enough to be president? Are you tough enough to be president?
Yes, I think so.
Yeah.
I mean, look, you've got to be a lot of different things to be a good president. You've got to start with really understanding what people are going through and trying to figure out how you can help everybody have a better shot at a future that they deserve. That's my mission in this campaign and as president. But there are problems in the world, and there are, believe it or not, some people who don't agree with us and might want to cause some mischief. So you do have to be prepared to do it in a sensible, smart way. Not bullying, but, you know, with a little more diplomacy. I think that's how you get the right combination.